Wait, what is this Fréchet distance again?
Maurice René Fréchet was a French mathematician of the first half of the 20th century. He made many important contributions to mathematics, topology, calculus, probability. He was also fluent in Esperanto. These days, he's arguably best known for having a distance named after him, the Fréchet distance.
The Fréchet distance is a powerful way to measure the similarity between two curves. Suppose we have two curves, A and B. Then the Fréchet distance is the maximum distance two points traveling on A and B ever need to be away from each other.
It's like the length of the leash.
To compute the Fréchet distance, we can make use of the free space diagram. For a given distance delta, we draw a two-dimensional diagram where each axis corresponds to the distance traveled along each curve, A and B. The free space is a part of the diagram where the distance between the two points is at most delta.
Free space diagrams were inspired by the notion of configuration space in, for instance, robotics, and were first introduced in 1995 by Helmut Alt and Michael Godot as a way to approach the Fréchet distance. Their seminal work initiated quite a lot of research into the computational complexity of the Fréchet distance.
The free space diagram is a way to see locally which pieces of the curves are close enough to each other to allow simultaneous traversal within a given distance delta. Once we have the free space diagram, we can test whether the Fréchet distance is smaller or larger than delta by searching for a bimonotone path within the free space. We can compute the Fréchet distance by optimizing over delta, for instance, using parametric search.
Whether it's possible to compute the Fréchet distance in subquadratic time is still a major open question.
What does the free space diagram look like in one dimension?
When we think of curves, we tend to think of them living in spaces of two or more dimensions. However, mathematically, there's no reason why a curve cannot be embedded in a one-dimensional space, that is, a line.
Similarity between one-dimensional curves is an important subject and has applications in time series analysis and signal processing.
Since the Fréchet distance does not depend on the dimension of the ambient space, we can still use it to measure the similarity between two one-dimensional curves.
It's like you and your dog walking back and forth on the same street.
A one-dimensional curve is just a sequence of distances alternating left and right. And this restricted motion has a profound effect on the structure and visual appearance of the free space diagram.
Let's do some geometry!
Because both curves either move in the same direction or in opposite directions, the boundaries of the free space diagram will always be lines of slope 1 or minus 1. For instance, we draw
one free space diagram.
The fact that the free space diagram is so regular and can be drawn so compactly might give us hope that one can break the quadratic time barrier in this case.
How do we use this to speed things up?
Well, the short answer is we do not know. But we can solve the problem efficiently for curves of bounded ply.
The ply of a spatial region is an important subject in many geometric studies.
It's like with toilet paper. The ply of a roll of toilet paper is the number of sheets of paper that are stacked on top of each other. So, for example, this particular roll has ply 2.
It is hard to pinpoint the origin of such a natural notion. But we can at least say that Victor Clay described this concept in 1977 in his paper "Can the union of n intervals be computed in less than log n steps?" where he called it depth. The term ply was first introduced in this context by Gary Miller, Shuahuang Ten, William Thurston and Stefan Vavasis in 1997.
In general, the concept of ply does not make sense for curves. However, in one dimension it does.
The ply of curve A corresponds exactly to the ply of this piece of paper when we fold it in only one direction.
For any vertical line, the number of intersections with the boundary of the free space is at most twice the ply of A. The same holds for horizontal lines and the ply of B. In particular, this implies that when both A and B have bounded ply K, computing the Fréchet distance becomes quite trivial. The diagram now only has complexity K times N, so we can construct it explicitly.
Yes!
And by construct, I mean compute. We can compute the Fréchet distance between two one-dimensional curves of bounded by k in order nk time.
Aren't there supposed to be gory technical details in this video?
Studies have shown that videos are more effective when they focus on more elementary material. However, we do not want to risk our viewers thinking we're not doing serious science here.
Even when only one of the curves is bounded by, we can make use of the special structure of the free space diagram to solve the problem more efficiently. The key is to consider the free space diagram between A and a line. Now we can see the other curve B is a sequence of vertical lines, and we're looking for a monotone path moving back and forth between those lines, touching them. We can do this because the free space is basically a sequence of slabs, all cut out of the same base diagram, as if we are folding the diagram along vertical lines.
Remember?
Because of this, we can maintain a set of reachable intervals on each vertical line, from which we compute the set of reachable intervals on the next line. To do this efficiently, we build a data structure for fast ray shooting queries.
Ray shooting data structures can efficiently answer questions of the type: if I shoot a ray in that direction, where do I hit? They are quite well understood. They date back to 1989 in computational geometry, and even early in computer graphics.
By using the data structure appropriately, we can decide in order nk time whether the Fréchet distance between a applied k curve and any other curve is smaller than delta.
So, once again, what was this about?
We have shown that deciding whether the Fréchet distance is smaller than delta for two one-dimensional curves, one of which has bounded by, can be done faster than in quadratic time.
The question of whether the Fréchet distance between unrestricted one-dimensional curves can be computed in subquadratic time remains open. We would like to boldly conjecture that it can.
One free space diagram.